J.R.D. Tata's death on 29th November 1993 received press coverage worthy of a prime minister. The parliament, in an unusual gesture for a private citizen, was adjourned in his memory, and the state of Maharashtra declared 3 days of mourning. Weeks after his death, articles, letters, advertisements and hoardings continued to appear. The well-known journalist M.V. Kamath wrote after JRD's death, "In his life, what JRD did was what any pilgrim might have wished to do. Go always a little further beyond the last blue mountain, wishing to know what lay there." As the pioneer of civil aviation in India, as the captain of an industrial empire, as a professional, as a philanthropist, as a citizen and a remarkable human being who led an extraordinary life, JRD says,
"I do not consider myself an illustrious personality, but only an ordinary businessman and a citizen who has tried to make the best of his opportunities to advance the cause of India's industrial and economic development. Any such guiding principles I might unconsciously have had in my life can be summarized as follows: that nothing worthwhile is ever achieved without deep thought and hard work. That one must think for oneself and never accept at their face value slogans and catchphrases to which, unfortunately, our people are too easily susceptible. That one must forever strive for excellence, or even perfection, in any task, however small, and never be satisfied with the second best. That no success or achievement in material terms is worthwhile unless it serves the needs or interests of the country and its people, and is achieved by fair and honest means. Good human relations not only bring great personal rewards, but are also essential to the success of any enterprise."
The life of J.R.D. Tata spanned almost the whole of the 20th century. He was born in Paris and he died in Geneva. In between, he spent over 70 years of his working life in India. During that period, he brought to India the gift of civil aviation in 1932 and later in 1948, helped the country spread her wings abroad by launching Air India International. Had he achieved nothing else, his place in India's Hall of Fame would still have been secure. But he did far, far more. Air India could not have been more apt in its eulogy to its founder and creator. "He touched the sky and it smiled. He stretched out his arms and they encircled the globe. His vision made giants out of men and organizations."
गगन की आट निशाना है भाई दाहिने सूर चंद्रमा बाए दिन के बीच छिपाना है भाई गगन की आट निशाना है भाई मारियो बाण घाव नहीं तन में जिन लागा तिन जाना है भाई तिन जाना है भाई जिन लागा तिन जाना है भाई कहे कबीर सुनो भाई साधो जिन जाना तिन माना है भाई गगन की ओट निशाना है भाई दाहिने सूर चंद्रमा बाए।
At the heart of the cultural life of Paris, then as now, stands l'Opéra. To the left of the opera is a spacious road, Rue des Halles. The second house on Rue des Halles is fairly modern, and it was there that Jahangir Ratanji Dadabhai Tata, the second child to Ratan Dadabhai Tata and Suni Tata, was born on 29th July 1904. Jahangir hailed from an illustrious family. His father, R.D. Tata, was a cousin and colleague of Jamshedji Tata, the man who brought the industrial revolution to India in the early 1900s, giving it steel, hydroelectric power and high-level technological education. Over 100 years ago, this enterprising merchant set up a mill in Nagpur to manufacture cotton goods and flagged off what was to become a giant industry, the Tata Group.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.